But the city's mayor, former world boxing champ Vitali Klitschko, vows Putin's troops will not enter this town. We met the mayor and his brother Vladimir Klitschko, himself a former boxing champion, in a secret location in Kyiv.
Do you think that you have what it takes to fend them off completely and that this city will not be taken by Russia?
It's our hometown. We fight. We never go to the knee. We don't want to be slaves. We don't want back to USSR to live in dictator, to live in authoritarianism. We see our country as modern European democratic country.
The Klitschkos are on the move 24/7, visiting residential areas shelled by the Russian army, sometimes getting emotional when seeing the aftermath of Russian attacks.
Putin says he's only targeting military targets.
Bullshit. Sorry. Where's military target?
Comforting those affected by the war and overseeing the effort to train those looking to confront Russian forces.
You've really stepped up and really have organized the defense of the city. How did you manage to do that, learn that so quickly, learning on the fly?
We don't need to organize. I meet people in blog post with very peaceful profession. Artist, musician, doctors. Never ever have idea to take the uniform and take the weapons in the hand. But right now, they in the street and ready to fight. A few days ago, the apartment building destroyed from racket. One man, around 60 years old, coming to me and ask what I have to do. What I have to do right now. I give him proposal to evacuate him to my safety zone, to west of Ukraine. He told, Mr. Klitschko, my mayor, I don't want to leave from my hometown. Please give me weapons. I am ready to defend my family, my lovely Kyiv. Instead the panic, demoralization, the people motivate so much and have spirit to defend our future.
But they're up against a strong and better equipped foe. As President Biden visits Europe to meet NATO allies, the Klitschko's messages get tougher on Putin.
What are your demands? What do you guys need to continue this fight?
Our will is strong, and it's better and stronger than any army and any weapon. But we definitely need to close our sky. Our civilians and our cities are getting destroyed. And it's continuing while we're giving this interview and speaking about it. The fights are still going on. We need supply of the defensive weapons. And you guys just need to stop any economical relationship with Russia. This way, we will isolate them, make him weaker, and just show that international law cannot be broken. Oil. Obviously, the world needs oil and gas, but it's better to pay higher price than to pay with lives for that oil.
And so you guys, obviously, or you want a no-fly zone, I gather, and aircraft, anti-aircraft systems, and the like to beat the Russians in the skies. That's one of the most important things, right?
If you supply us with defensive weapons, we're going to close the skies on our own. We have enough men and women that are going to stand for the country and will defend it as strong, as much as possible. And we're going to close the sky on our own. We just need the defensive equipment for that.
Vitali Klitschko knows Joe Biden well. The two met both in Washington, D.C. and in Kyiv when Biden was vice president and the U.S. frontman for Ukraine policy in the Obama administration.
What's your message to Joe Biden as he comes to Europe?
Stay with Ukraine. Thank you very much for support. Support Ukraine. With our friends, we are much stronger. It's our future. It's our freedom. We're ready to fight for that. But we need support for the whole democratic world.
The Klitschkos are international celebrities with massive fan bases in both the U.S. and in Europe. And yet they say for them there is no other place they want to be than in Kyiv, despite the dangers.
You're some of the prime targets for the Russians. You know, they're out to get you. Why do you do it? Or what motivates you?
It's our homeland. It's our parents here. We've grown up. It's our country. It's our home. And the simple answer, we have to be here.
Do you know this expression of roots? Mm. Our roots are here. Our father, that was one of the Chernobyl survivors, and he was one of the liquidators that buried in Kyiv, and he's Ukrainian as it could be. Our relatives, our friends, every single street reminds us on some memories in life. And that's something that gives you so much strength, because the truth is on our side. This is pretty much reminds me, like in a fairy tale, the fight between the good and the evil.